everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to start weekly current affairs analysis. This is for all kinds of competitive examinations, but I have focused mainly on UPSC civil service examination. So people who are going to watch the particular segment, they should know ki unka focus kin points pe hona chahiye while they are going through the lesson with me. So let's get started. So the first thing that you need to focus is obviously the headline. Okay, the second thing is how to analyze between the lines. Between the lines ka matlab hota hai jo cheez newspaper mein likhi nahi jati, samjhai nahi jati, un cheezon ko samajh lena. And the third thing of course is how and what to read and note. Newspaper ka video aapne dekh liya hoga to aapko samajh mein aa jayega ki kaun se headlines aapke liye zaruri hai. Not everything in the newspaper is important. Sports ke news ho gaya, business related koi news hai, stock market and all that is not important for you. So do watch the newspaper reading video for sure. I'll be putting the link in the description box. And जैसे जैसे हम न्यूज़ को डिस्कस करते जाएंगे, you will see कौन से पॉइंट सबसे ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है टू नोट डाउन. पेपर को सिंपली लेकर कट पेस्ट करना इज नॉट नोट मेकिंग आउट ऑफ द न्यूज़ पेपर. ठीक है, सो कैसे मैंने हेडलाइंस को क्रॉप किया, कॉम्प्रेस किया और कौन से पॉइंट्स मैंने इंक्लूड किए हैं, आप वो भी समझते जाइएगा. नाउ लेट्स गेट क्विकली स्टार्टेड विद द फर्स्ट हेडलाइन. So the first headline talks about ICC ruling on jurisdiction in Palestinian territory. Headline ko dekhte hi samajh aata hai international relation ka topic hai. Theek hai, agar nahi aaya to syllabus ko hamesha apne saath rakhiye. So headline mein kya likha hai? The International Criminal Court said that the court has jurisdiction over war crimes committed in the Palestinian territory. Now let's look at the story of Israel and Palestine's conflict. कहानी को शुरू करने से पहले सम इम्पॉर्टेंट ज्योग्राफिकल फैक्ट्स. वेस्ट बैंक इज लोकेटेड टू द वेस्ट ऑफ जॉर्डन रिवर, लैंडलॉक टेरिटरी बॉर्डर्ड बाय जॉर्डन टू ईस्ट एंड इजराइल टू द साउथ वेस्ट एंड नॉर्थ. गाजा स्ट्रिप इज अ स्मॉल बूट शेप टेरिटरी अलोंग विद मेडिटेरेनियन कोस्ट बिटवीन इजिप्ट एंड इजराइल. अब कहानी शुरू होती है वर्ल्ड वॉर वन से, जहां बोथ वेस्ट बैंक एंड गाजा स्ट्रिप बिकेम पार्ट ऑफ ब्रिटिश मैंडेटेड पैलेस्टीन. At the end of the war of World War II, there was a strong demand from the Jews fleeing Nazi Europe for a homeland within Palestine. Arab-dominated region tha Palestine us samay. Jerusalem is considered to be holy place by the Jews. Now, after the end of British mandate in Palestine in 1947, United Nations came with a plan of partition of Palestine. Arab or Jewish ke beech Palestine ko baanta jaye. 53% of the land was given to Jewish majority state of Israel and 47% to Palestine majority state Palestine. Now the idea of creating new Jewish majority state did not go well for Arab countries in the Middle East. They did not like it. So there was a war, and at the end of the war in 1949, Israel had taken up to 78% of the historical Palestine. Palestinian territory shrank to 22%. Of what it had earlier been. Unko pehle 47 diya gaya tha, ab 22% hi bacha. Meanwhile, the West Bank and the East Jerusalem came under Jordan's rule, while West Jerusalem to Israel. And aapko pata hai ki Jerusalem is the holy place for Jews. The Gaza Strip was under Egyptian military rule after the 1949 war. Now, in 1967, the Arab countries again refused to recognize Israel as a state, which led to another war known as the Six-Day War. Israel again won the war and occupied even more parts of Palestine. The West Bank, Gaza Strip, East Jerusalem, Syrian Golan Heights and Egypt's Sinai Peninsula. Ye sari cheeze ab Israel ne jeet li thi. That's all you need to know about the conflict. Now let us see the responses to the ruling. On the ruling, Israel had to say that ICC was investigating Israel for fake war crimes. That is, they were acting as pure anti-Semitism. Semitism ka jo term hai use kiya jata hai towards hostility or discrimination against Jews as religious, ethnic or racial group. United States bhi object kar raha hai ICC ke decision ko. While Palestine has welcomed it, we welcome the ruling, and it said it was a historic day and that Israel had previously been treated above the law. अब ICC के ruling पे इतने major reactions क्यों आ रहे हैं? आखिर ICC है क्या? So ICC is governed by international treaty, that is the Roman Statute. 2002 में it became world's first international criminal court. It investigates, tries individuals charged with gravest crimes of concern to international community, genocide, war crimes, crimes against humanity and crime of aggression. It aims to hold responsible for their crimes and to help prevent these crimes from happening again. It intends to complement, not replace, national criminal systems. That is, it prosecutes cases only when states do not or are unwilling or unable to do so. जब दो कंट्रीज के बीच वॉर क्राइम्स बढ़ गए हैं या ऐसे कोई सिचुएशन पैदा हो रही है जिससे ह्यूमैनिटी को खतरा है और वो दोनों देश कुछ नहीं कर पा रहे इस प्रॉब्लम को सुलझाने के लिए, तब आईसीसी वहां पे इंटरफेयर करता है. ओके, सो ये पॉइंट्स जितने भी आपके सामने भी हैं आपको याद रखने हैं और इसी तरह से इतना ही रिसर्च करके आपको सारे हेडलाइंस को समझना है. ये पहला जो हेडलाइन है वो इतनी ज्यादा डिटेल में वी आर डिस्कसिंग सो दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड कितना इन्फॉर्मेशन जरूरी है. आपको पीएचडी नहीं करना है, आपको आईसीसी का पूरा इतिहास जानने की जरूरत नहीं है, बस ये बेसिक पॉइंट्स याद रखने ताकि आपको याद रहे कि आईसीसी आखिर है क्या. अब इंडियन सिविल सर्विस के एग्जामिनेशन की तैयारी हो रही है सो इंडिया का स्टैंड जानना और समझना जरूरी है. अब इसराइल चाहता है कि इंडिया आईसीसी के अगेंस्ट स्टैंड ले, बट इंडिया इज रिलक्टेंट टू डू सो क्योंकि इंडिया के खुद के जियोपॉलिटिकल इंटरेस्ट बहुत अलग है. इंडिया इस्लामिक स्टेट्स को नाराज नहीं करना चाहता. ये जो पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट है वो न्यूज़पेपर में नहीं मिलेगा, ये समझना पड़ेगा. ठीक है, सो जब हम इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस के लेसन्स पढ़ेंगे तब आपको समझ में आएगा कि इंडिया का हिस्टोरिकली रिलेशंस अपने जो नेबरहुड कंट्रीज है और बाकी इंटरनेशनल इंपॉर्टेंट कंट्रीज हैं उनके साथ कैसा रहा है, तब आपको उसका जियोपॉलिटिकल इंटरेस्ट भी समझ में आएगा. अभी फिलहाल इतना याद रखिए कि इसराइल का साथ देने के लिए तैयार नहीं है इंडिया क्योंकि वो इस्लामिक स्टेट्स को नाराज नहीं करना चाहता है क्योंकि उसके खुद के जियोपॉलिटिकल इंटरेस्ट हैं. Now another reason India has conveyed to Israel through its diplomatic channels is that we are not a member of Roman Statute, so we won't be able to comment or take a stand on the decision of the court. Part of your homework today, learn about Roman Statute. Now what are the outcomes of the ruling by the ICC? Because of this ruling, in 53 years, pehli baar ye sare war crimes ke upar criminal investigations kiya jayega. और इसराइल और पैलेस्तीन के मिलिटेंट ग्रुप्स इंक्लूडिंग हमस पे इन्वेस्टिगेशन होगा और जो गलत होगा उसे सजा दी जाएगी. जो 53 इयर्स से जस्टिस की वेट कर रहे हैं उन सबको जस्टिस सर्व किया जाएगा और जो जिम्मेदार है उसे सजा मिलेगी. सो दिस इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रूलिंग. लेट्स लुक एट द सेकंड हेडलाइन, जियोस्पेशियल सेक्टर डीरेगुलेटेड. सो द हेडलाइन सेज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी हैज रिलीज्ड new guidelines for geospatial sector in India which deregulates existing protocol and liberalizes the sector to a more competitive field. This is an interlinked topic, science and tech or economy ki baat karenge ya. So first of all, what is geospatial data? See, ye data is about objects, events or phenomena that have a location on the surface of the earth. Ye uska basic definition hai. The location may be static in short term like a location of a road, an earthquake event or dynamic like a moving vehicle or pedestrian, the spread of an infectious disease. All of this can be covered using geospatial data. You can find out about these things using geospatial data. Ab ye government ke liye isliye important hai because government uses this data for infrastructure planning, सोशल डेवलपमेंट, नेचुरल कैलामिटीज पे नजर रखना या यू नो कहाँ पे कैलामिटी हुई है, कितना नुकसान हुआ है, ये सारी चीज़ें को रिकॉर्ड करने में जियोस्पेशियल डेटा बहुत ज़्यादा हेल्प करता है. पास्ट डिकेड में देर इज बीन एन इंक्रीज इन द यूज ऑफ जियोस्पेशियल डेटा इन डेली लाइफ विद वेरियस एप्स सच एज फूड डिलीवरी एप्स जैसे स्विगी, जोमैटो, ई कॉमर्स जो एप्स हैं, कंपनीज हैं वो इसका काफ़ी इस्तेमाल करती है लाइक अमेजोन और इवन वेदर डेटाज. सो लास्ट डिकेड में इसका इस्तेमाल बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ा है और इसी वजह से डीरेगुलेट करने का फैसला सरकार ने लिया है. अब ये क्यों लिया है इसे समझते हैं. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ व्हाट इज द प्रेजेंट पॉलिसी ऑन जियोस्पेशियल डेटा और क्या चेंजेस आए. सो देर आर स्ट्रिक्ट रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन द कलेक्शन, स्टोरेज, यूज, सेल, डिसेमिनेशन ऑफ जियोस्पेशियल डेटा एंड मैपिंग अंडर द करंट रिजीम ड्रिवन बाय इंटरनल एज वेल एज एक्सटर्नल सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न्स. सो नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड कि सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न्स की वजह से जियोस्पेशियल डेटा पे बहुत सारे रिस्ट्रिक्शंस हैं. इवन प्राइवेट कंपनीज जो हैं उनको भी एक पूरा एक सीरीज ऑफ यू नो एक सिस्टम है जिसको फॉलो करना पड़ता है इफ दे वॉन्ट टू कलेक्ट, क्रिएट और डिसेमिनेट जियोस्पेशियल डेटा. अब बदलाव क्या क्या लाए गए. So under this deregulation policy, geospatial data that was earlier restricted will now be freely available for Indian companies in India. जो भारत की companies हैं, भारत में जो companies हैं, उनको freely available होंगी, उनको कोई permission लेने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, ना ही कोई उनपे restrictions होगा. Before they collect, generate, prepare, disseminate, store, publish, update digital geospatial data and maps within the territory of India. So now let's understand the benefits of deregulation. So the first benefit is increased competitiveness in the sectors using geospatial data. Evidence-based policy making होगी, startups को boost मिलेगा, आत्मनिर्भर भारत के तहत indigenous app developments होंगे जिनमें geospatial data की जरूरत पड़ती है, employment generation होगा and increased investment and boost to economy. Now the next headline is about oil and gas projects in Tamil Nadu. अब ऐसे headlines में कौन से points याद रखने और note down करने, let's look at that. So this is a part of GS paper 3. Prime Minister has laid foundation of key projects of oil and gas in Tamil Nadu. So the inauguration is of Ramanathapuram Thuthukudi natural gas pipeline. The pipeline is a section of Innanur, Thiruvalluvar, Bengaluru, Puducherry, Nagapattinam, Madurai, Tuticorin natural gas pipeline. अब इस प्रोजेक्ट से बेनिफिट किसको होगा? सो इट्स गोइंग टू बेनिफिट इंडस्ट्रीज एंड कमर्शियल कस्टमर्स. गैसोलाइन डीसल्फराइजेशन यूनिट शैल बी इनॉग्रेटेड एट चेन्नई पेट्रोलियम कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी प्रीटी इको फ्रेंडली सिंस इट्स गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस लो सल्फर, दैट इज लेस देन 8 पार्ट्स पर मिलियन. सो दैट्स इट, दैट इज ऑल यू नीड टू रिमेंबर फ्रॉम दिस हेडलाइन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट हेडलाइन इज फ्रॉम जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 1 सोसाइटी टॉपिक देवेंद्र कुला वेल्लार. So the headline is talking about delisting of a community from SC, which is misinformation according to Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So the ministry has stated that the cabinet has approved for categorizing 7 SC communities into Devendra Kula Vellar. A bill for categorizing these communities under the SC, that is scheduled caste list, is already introduced in the Lok Sabha. The Pallar, who prefers to be called Mallar, is a Tamil subcaste of peasant found in Tamil Nadu. Okay, so the community members refers to themselves as Devendra Kula Vellalar, DKV, a name reflecting that they were created by God Devendra. Coming to the next headline, Sandy's, which is an instant messaging platform. So this is a part of GS Paper 3 Science and Tech. Now Sandy's is launched by NIC and it is very much similar to WhatsApp. NIC is an attached office under Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Jo interface hai, use hai is application ka, is platform ka, is similar to all the messaging, you know, apps available today. And NIC ke bare mein information that you all should know is that it provides infrastructural support to IT services and delivery of some of the initiatives of Digital India. Next headline, Mahabahu Brahmaputra to be launched. So now you should know this is a part of GS Paper 3 Infra. Always keep your syllabus with you. And this project is launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Assam. Remember this. Ropex vessel operation shuru kiye jayenge between Nimati Majauli Islands, North Guwahati, South Guwahati and Dhubri Hastings Margi. Is project ka shilanyas kiya gaya at Jogi Hopa Terminal. बहुत सारे टूरिस्ट जेटीज भी अवेलेबल अब करवाए जाएंगे ऑन रिवर ब्रह्मपुत्र. लॉन्च ऑफ डिजिटल सॉल्यूशंस फॉर ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्रोजेक्ट एंड द एम इज टू प्रोवाइड सीमलेस कनेक्टिविटी टू ईस्टर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया. द नेक्स्ट हेडलाइन इज अबाउट लेदर बैक सी टर्टल. द हेडलाइन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट कंजर्वेशनिस्ट हु आर वरीड अबाउट द ऑलिव लेदर बैक टर्टल एंड नीति आयोग हैज लेड डाउन प्रपोजल्स फॉर टूरिज्म एंड पोर्ट डेवलपमेंट इन अंडमान निकोबार आइलैंड्स. Now, Niti Aayog's tourism vision has this proposal that they are going to make this mega shipment port at Galathea Bay on Great Nicobar Island. Also, the Little Andaman plan proposes phased growth of tourism on this untouched island, unexplored island, which may lead to the de-reservation of over 200 square kilometer of rainforest and also about 140 square kilometer of Ongi Tribal Reserve. Now let us see, leatherback sea turtle aakhir hai kya? So it is one of the largest of 7 species of sea turtle. Other species are olive ridley turtle, you must have heard about them, green turtle, hawksbill turtle, lodgerhead turtle, leatherback turtle. So except the lodgerback, the remaining 4 species nest along the Indian coast. Ab samajh mein aaya ki Niti Aayog ki jo maine baat ki, jo headline mein mention kiya gaya hai, और ये जो लेदर बैक टर्टल, इन दोनों के जो टॉपिक्स है वो क्यों एक यू नो लिंक्ड है एक दूसरे से. Now this leatherback sea turtle is found in all oceans except Arctic and Antarctic. Within the Indian Ocean, they nest only in Indonesia, Sri Lanka and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. It is the only living species in the genus Dermochelys and family Dermochelidae. It can easily be differentiated from other modern sea turtles by its lack of a bony shell. They are listed in Schedule 1 of India's Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. Apologies for the construction noise. Now, Ministry of Environment has released National Marine Turtle Action Plan, in which Andaman and Nicobar Islands are given prominent importance. According to this plan, India has identified all its important sea turtle nesting habitats as important coastal and marine biodiversity areas. These areas have been included in the Coastal Regulation Zone, CRZ1. South Bay and West Bay on Little Andaman and Galathea on Great Nicobar are mentioned as important marine turtle habitats in India. Now the next headline, Pilot Bay Jal Sarvekshan launched. So, Pilot Bay Jal Sarvekshan under Jal Jeevan Mission Urban, that is JJMU, was launched recently. Ministry, kaun sa ministry ke under aayega? Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Now, on a pilot basis, it is conducted in cities to ascertain equitable distribution of water, reuse of wastewater, and mapping of water bodies with respect to quantity and quality of water through a challenge process. So, it will be first launched in 10 cities of Agra, Badlapur, Bhubaneswar, Churu, Kochi, Madurai, Patiala, Rohtak, Surat, and Tumkur. As you know, Jal Jeevan Mission ka jo aim hai, and that is to provide water to all households. Every tap should have water supply. So JJMU is designed to provide that in the urban areas, okay, and in all 4378 statutory towns in accordance with the Sustainable Development Goal number 6. Now the next headline is on Technographs, which has been recently launched. So on an enrollment module basis, Technographies has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Now, what are the key takeaways from the news article? Technographies are students from IITs, NITs, Engineering, Planning and Architecture College, faculty members, academicians and stakeholders. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs is promoting 6 lighthouse projects as live laboratories for transfer of technology to the field. So the lighthouse projects are model housing projects. About 1,000 of them are to be created, and interested candidates can register themselves to visit these live laboratories in LHP, that is live lighthouse project sites, for learning, for consultation, generation of ideas and solution, experimentation, innovation and technical awareness. They will also get regular updates from the sites for information dissemination till the completion of the lighthouse project. So the next headline is about NASA's Perseverance and China. So NASA's Perseverance and China's Tianwen 1 are set to land. NASA's Perseverance has already successfully landed on Mars on Feb 18, and China's Xiaowa 1 is going to land in May 2021. So NASA's Perseverance is one of the most sophisticated missions. It has landed successfully on Jezero crater on the 18th of Feb, which was likely filled with water in the past. So this crater was filled in the past with water. That is what has been thought of. And it is NASA's fourth generation Mars rover. And the goal is to look for biosignatures in the dried up lake bed at the Jezero crater. Let's talk about Tianwen 1. So it is first mission to Mars from China. And it carries an orbiter, a lander and a rover. All of these things you'll understand when I'll be taking your science and tech lessons. But for now, itna yaad rakho. These are the points you need to remember. It will orbit Mars for a few months before attempting to land in May this year. The next headline, eChavni portal launched. So this is a portal plus mobile app that has been launched by Ministry of Defense. The objective is to provide online civic service to over 20 lakh residents of 62 cantonment boards across India. So through this portal, the residents of cantonment areas will be able to avail basic services like renewal of leases, application of birth and death certificate, water and sewage connections, etc. It is developed by eGov Foundation, Bharat Electronics Limited, Directorate General Defense Estates and National Informatics Center. Apologies for the construction noise. Now coming to the next headline, constitutional provisions of the governor. So the headline is to do with Dr. Kiran Bedi's removal as Puducherry's lieutenant governor. Now let's look at some articles. Article 153, there shall be a governor for each state. One person can be appointed as governor for two or more states. The governor acts in dual capacity as the constitutional head of the state and as the representative. He acts as a bridge between union and state governments. Article 157 and 158 talks about eligibility requirements. A governor must be citizen of India, 35 years of age, not be a member of either house of the parliament or house of state legislature. He should not hold any office of profit. The term of office is 5 years, and the office or the term can be terminated earlier by dismissal by the president on the advice of the council of ministers, dismissal by the president whose acts are upheld by courts as unconstitutional and malafide, resignation by the governor himself or herself. Ab mudda ye nahi hai ki unko hataya kyun gaya, theek hai, usse aapka koi lena dena nahi hai. You should not be interested in news that are related to some controversies or political matters, theek hai. All you need to know is about the governor. Now the next headline is about Gozi Okonjo-Iweala, who was appointed as the head of World Trade Organization. She is the first female and first African to hold the role in its history. She is a former finance minister of Nigeria, and she will serve a 4-year term as the director general. WTO is an international body that deals with the rules of trade between nations. Next headline, green hydrogen. So hydrogen produced from fossil fuels is called grey hydrogen. This constitutes the bulk of hydrogen produced today. Hydrogen generated from fossil fuels with carbon capture and storage options is called blue hydrogen. Hydrogen generated entirely from renewable power sources is called green hydrogen. So teen tarah ke hydrogen hai, grey, blue and green. So headline mein green hydrogen ki baat ki gayi hai. Now in the last process, electricity generated from renewable energy is used to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. Now let's talk about specific advantages of green hydrogen. The first one is it is environment friendly. Secondly, it has the potential to decarbonize various sectors. It uses renewable energy efficiently. It is good for energy security. It has reduced our dependence on rare minerals, and also it will help us in fulfilling the Paris goals. Now the next headline is about 75 years of Sri Ramchandra Mission. So this is part of Culture GS Paper 1. The Prime Minister recently addressed the event organized to commemorate 75 years of Sri Ramchandra Mission. So Sri Ramchandra Mission is a non-profit organization and a spiritual movement originating in India. It teaches the practice of Sahaj Marg or heartfulness meditation. It was registered in 1945 by Ramchandra of Shahjahanpur. In this kind of meditation, the processes involved are of meditation, internal cleansing and prayer. Now let's talk about CECPA, Comprehensive Economic Cooperation and Partnership Agreement. So this is a part of GS Paper 2, International Relations. The Union Cabinet has approved signing of CECPA between India and Mauritius. So this will be the first trade agreement between India and Mauritius, and it is a limited agreement. It will cover trade in goods, rules of origin, trade in services, technical barriers to trade, sanitary, phytosanitary measures, dispute settlement, movement of natural persons, telecom, financial services, custom procedures and cooperation in other areas. Now CECPA provides for an institutional mechanism to encourage and improve trades between two countries. Okay, so both the sides have also agreed, that is India and Mauritius have agreed, to negotiate on an automatic trigger safeguard mechanism, ATSM, for a limited number of highly sensitive products within 2 years of signing of the agreement. The next headline is going to talk about amendment to the Juvenile Justice Act. This is a part of Society, Paper 1, GS Paper 1 and also GS Paper 2, Policies and Interventions. So the amendments are going to bring more clarity about the provisions of Juvenile Justice Act. And ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा जो अब ज़िम्मेदारी है इन provisions को implement करने की वो अब bureaucrats को दे दी जाएंगी, the district magistrates, right? So what is Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015? So updated legislation है, it was introduced and passed in 2015 and it replaced the Juvenile Delinquency Law and the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act of 2000. So to change in nomenclature, the act changes the nomenclature from juvenile to child or child in conflict. with law. So also it removes the negative connotation associated with the word juvenile. So ab juvenile ki jagah child in trouble with law ka istemal kiya jayega. Now there are special provisions for age 16 to 18. One of the main provisions of the new act was that juveniles charged with heinous crimes and who are between the ages of 16 to 18 will be tried as adults and processed through the adult justice system. This provision received an impetus after the 2012 Delhi gang rape case in which one of the accused was just short of 18 years of age. Now the new provision say that juvenile justice board har district mein establish kiye jayenge so that it could be determined whether the accused is to be treated as a minor or a child or as an adult. And ek child welfare committee bhi banayi jayegi har district mein jisme ek member women honi hi chahiye. So one of at least one women member honi chahiye. One more important part is adoption related clauses. So another major provision was that the act streamlined adoption procedures for orphans, abandoned and surrendered children, and the existing Central Adoption Resource Authority CARA has been given the status of statutory body to enable it to perform its functions even more efficiently. Now, inclusion of new offenses. The act included several new offenses committed against children like illegal adoptions, use of child by militant groups, offenses against disabled children, etc., which are not adequately covered under any law. In sabko include kiya gaya hai in the amendment in the new provisions. Now the amendments passed by the union government, sabse pehle the inclusion of serious crimes apart from heinous crimes. So pehli bar heinous or serious crimes ko clarify kiya gaya taki koi ambiguity na rahe, confusion na rahe. The heinous crimes with a maximum imprisonment of 7 years pertain mostly to sexual offenses and violent sexual crimes. Crime like possession and sale of an illegal substance such as drugs or alcohol will now fall under the ambit of serious crime. The second amendment is about expanding the purview of district and additional district magistrate. So DM or ADMs will be monitoring the functioning of various agencies that are under Juvenile Justice Act in every district. This will include all the child welfare committees, juvenile justice boards, the district child protection units and the special juvenile protection units. Also, no new children's home will be opened without the sanction of the DM. He has to make sure that all the, you know, child welfare protection units are following the norms and procedures. Earlier ye relaxed tha, ye kisi ke under mein nahi aa raha tha, that nobody was overlooking ke wo kaise kaam kar rahe, but ab DM ko dekhna padega, theek hai. The DM will also carry out background checks of child welfare committee members ke agar kisi member ke khilaf koi child abuse ya sexual abuse case hai ya nahi, unka education qualification kya hai, ye etc. jo cheeze hain wo ab DM dhyan rakhenge. Now about adoption, to hasten the process and make it smoother for the children's rehabilitation into their homes or foster homes. Ab amendment further ye changes laega ki jo district magistrate hai, now he or she will be in charge of sanctioning adoptions. Pehle court jana padta tha, ab DMs hi adoption sanction karenge. So now let's talk about the process of delimitation in respect to the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. So recently delimitation commission ki meeting hui with the associate members of Jammu and Kashmir, and objective tha ki वो सजेशंस ले उनसे कैसे डिलिमिटेशन का प्रोसेस जो है अब धीरे धीरे इंप्लीमेंट किया जाए जम्मू कश्मीर में. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड डिलिमिटेशन है क्या. सो इट इज एन एक्ट ऑफ रीड्रॉइंग द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ लोकसभा एंड स्टेट असेंबली सीट्स. ऑब्जेक्टिव ये है कि इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन मिले इक्वल सेगमेंट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन को और फेयर ज्योग्राफिकल डिविजन किया जाए किसी जगह का, सो दैट एक पोलिटिकल पार्टी को एडवांटेज ना मिल सके दूसरे पॉलिटिकल पार्टी पे इन द इलेक्शंस. ओके, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजन में आर्टिकल 82 है जिसके तहत पार्लियामेंट कैन इनएक्ट डिलिमिटेशन एक्ट आफ्टर एवरी सेंसस. डिलिमिटेशन कमीशन इंडिपेंडेंटली डिलिमिटेशन प्रोसेस को पूरा करता है, एंड चार बार डिलिमिटेशन कमीशन को सेटअप किया गया है, 1952 में, 1963, 73 एंड 2002 में. देयर इज नो डिलिमिटेशन आफ्टर द 1981 एंड 1991 सेंसस. Now the next headline talks about WCCB wins Asia Environmental Enforcement Award 2020. So the Wildlife Crime Control Bureau has received the Asia Environmental Enforcement Award 2020. This is awarded by United Nations Environment Program, and WCCB ko ye dusra award mila hai in 3 years. It has been awarded this year under the innovation category. Now let's quickly see what is WCCB. So it's a statutory body under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972 under Ministry of Environment and Forest. The mandate is to combat organized wildlife crime in the country. The headquarters is in New Delhi, regional offices BASK, Delhi, Kolkata, Mumbai, Chennai or Jabalpur. WCCB has developed an online wildlife crime database management system to get real-time data to analyze trends in wildlife crimes across India. Now, this system is so successfully used kiya gaya in operations such as Operation Save, Kurma, Thunderbird and many other operations, and that has led to the seizure of tiger leopard skin, rhino horns, elephant ivory, etc. And this being so successful, that is one of the reasons it has been awarded twice in 3 years. The next headline is about Hyderabad, Tree Cities of the World. So this is part of GS Paper 3 Environment. Hyderabad has won a green contest among cities in India and emerged one of the Tree Cities of the World. So ye award diya jata hai by Arbor Day Foundation and the Food and Agriculture Organization. Hyderabad has maintained urban forestry under its Harita Haram program and its Urban Forest Parks plan. The city was evaluated on 5 metrics given year. Established responsibility, set the rules, know what you have, allocating the resources and celebrating the achievements. Next headline is on Greenpeace analysis of cost to the economy due to air pollution. So Greenpeace Southeast Asia recently carried out analysis of cost to the economy due to air pollution. According to the report, air pollution claimed approximately 54,000 lives in Delhi in 2020. 6 Indian cities, Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Chennai, Hyderabad and Lucknow have featured in the global analysis, and globally 1,60,000 deaths were here because of air pollution, and these deaths have occurred in the cities. 5 most popular cities, Delhi, Mexico, Sao Paulo, Shanghai and Tokyo. So they have used cost estimator tool, and iska matlab ye that this particular tool gives real-time health impact and economic cost that has been suffered by the major cities of the world because of air pollution. Now let's talk about the next headline, trials for Helena and Dhruvastra carried out. So joint user trials for Helena and Dhruvastra have been carried out from advanced light helicopter platform in desert ranges. So Helena is a helicopter launched version of NAAG anti-tank guided missile. Dhruvastra is its Air Force variant. Now let's talk about Helena in detail. So Helena is a third generation lock-on before launch fire and forget class anti-tank guided missile system. So it has all weather day and night operational capabilities. It can defeat battle tanks with conventional and explosive reactive armor, engage targets both in direct hit mode as well as top tank mode. Dhruvastra has similar properties as well, and however it has been developed by DRDO. Now the next headline is about launch of Go Electric campaign. So, objective of the campaign is to spread awareness on benefits of e-mobility and EV charging infrastructure and electric cooking in India. Further, the campaign would help in reducing the import dependence. Sabse zyada to wo hamare liye actually zaruri hai to reduce our import dependence. It would be an important step towards a cleaner, greener future. It will also boost the confidence of EV manufacturers. And some important facts here. Electric fuel is a major alternative for fossil fuels. These fuels have an import bill of 8 lakh crore rupees. So 8 lakh crore rupees hamare bach jayenge agar hum ye campaign ke tahat awareness spread karna shuru kare, theek hai, aur apne jo companies hai, manufacturers hai, unko support karna shuru kare. The electric fuel has low cost, reduced emissions. And the plus point is, it is indigenous. Now let's talk about Tropics 21. So it is theater level operational readiness exercise that has been held at Kochi. The exercise involves 3 commands of Indian Navy, the Tri-Service Command at Port Blair, elements of Indian Army, Indian Air Force and Coast Guard. It is held every 2 years. It is the largest exercise conducted by Indian Navy. So ye Tropics 21 Indian Navy se related hai, theek hai, ye yaad rakhna zaruri hai. Now let's see why INS Pralay is in news. So Indian level ship Pralay arrived at Abu Dhabi. It shall participate in NEVDEX 21, that is Naval Defence Exhibition, and IDEX 21, International Defence Exhibition, scheduled from 20 to 25th February 2021. Now let's talk about conclusive land titling. So in 2020, even after the farm laws were passed and labor code reforms were being enacted, the government's think tank Niti Aayog took steps to initiate land reforms by drafting model bill on conclusive land titling. So what is the meaning of land titling? It is simply the process of handing the land from the previous owner to the future owner. Now let's look at the new system in detail. So the title is granted by the government, which takes the responsibility for accuracy. So government ki puri zimmedari hai. Once a title is granted, any other claimant will have to settle disputes with the government and not the title holder. Theek hai? So jisko zameen mili usse ladna nahi hai, usko jaake government se complain karni hai ki aapne ye land isko kyun diya hai. Theek hai? Further, under conclusive land titling, the government may provide compensation to the claimants in case of disputes, but the title holder is not in any danger of losing the ownership. So ho sakta hai uska jo nuksan hua hai, jo claimant hai uska nuksan hua hai, usko wo government wo paise de de, lekin jo jiske naam par ab zameen hai usse uski zameen nahi chhini jayegi. Theek hai? The bill circulated by Niti Aayog in 2020 calls for the land authorities to be set up by each state government, which will appoint a title registration officer TRO to prepare and publish a draft list of land titles based on the existing records and documents. Ab challenges kya in provisions ko implement karne mein? There is lack of updation, issue of inheritance can create more problems instead of solving problems. Federal setup hai and weak local bodies. Now the next headline is about Population versus Planet conference that has been held recently. So Population versus Planet conference is a part of Vion and Zee Media's year-long campaign called Mission Sustainability, Population versus Planet. So the key findings are that the world population has witnessed an increase from 1 billion in the year 1800 to 7.8 billion today. India's population has increased from 36 crores in 1951 to 121.02 crores in 2011. It has witnessed significant decline in both fertility and mortality rates. The birth rate has reduced from 40.8 per thousand in 1951 to 20.0 in 2018. So these are the datas, you need to remember them. Total fertility rate has declined from 6.0 in 1951 to 2.2 in 2015-16. Death rate in India has declined from 7 in 2012 to 6.2 in 2018. According to population projection for India and states 2011 to 2036, the TFR is expected to decline further. The youth population in the age group of 15 to 24 is projected to decline from 233 million in 2011 to 227 million in 2036. The proportion of the working age population is expected to increase from 61% in 2011 to 65% in 2036. Let's talk about Governing Council Niti Aayog. Recently, sixth meeting of the Governing Council of Niti Aayog was held. And Governing Council consists of the chief ministers of all states and the lieutenant governors of the union territories. So agenda kya set kiya tha for the sixth meeting? So it was about making India a manufacturing powerhouse, reimagining agriculture, improving physical infrastructure, accelerating human resource development, improving service delivery at grassroots levels and health and nutrition. So the Indian president recently addressed Sri Guru Ravidas Vishwa Mahapeeth Rashtriya Adhiveshan in New Delhi. So who was Sri Guru Ravidas? He was a Dalit poet saint. He belonged to the Bhakti movement era. He probably lived during 14th to 16th century. Wo ek leather working Chamar community ko belong karte the. The 41 hymns of Guru Ravidas have been included in Guru Granth Sahib, and the famous saint poetess Mirabai was a disciple of Guru Ravidas. So his teachings were that everybody is equal in all respects, irrespective of caste, color or a belief in any form of God. He emphasized on universal brotherhood and tolerance. Unhone kaha ki God created man and man has not created God. He abundant saguna, that is with attributes, image, forms of supreme beings, and focused on the nirguna, without attributes or form of supreme beings. Yani wo idol mein believe nahi karte the, theek hai? The next one is about VLSRSAM, that is Vertical Launch Short Range Surface to Air Missile. So Defense Research and Development Organization, that is DRDO, conducted two successful launches of VLSRSAM. Okay, it is developed for Indian Navy, indigenously designed and developed by DRDO. This is meant for neutralizing various aerial threats at close range, including sea skimming targets. So these launches were carried out for demonstration of vertical launch capability. The next headline is on JB ICA committee that is to be formed. So a one-man committee under Principal Secretary Dr. JB ICA will be formed for equal wages of small T workers of Assam. So T workers ke liye ye committee banai jayegi. And the Assam government has announced the increase in wage of tea garden workers from 167 rupees to 217 rupees per day. The tea garden managements pay the wages which is fixed by the government. The tea tribe community of Assam also faces exploitation, economic backwardness, poor health conditions and low literacy rates. In Union Budget 2020-21, rupees 1000 crore was announced for the welfare of tea workers of Assam and West Bengal. So the next headline is talking about Reserve Bank of India has released the annual report of the Ombudsman Scheme for 2019-20. So it has three ombudsmans: banking, NBFC and digital transactions. A common man can approach these ombudsmans for their grievances. These schemes are being merged and integrated into a single scheme which will be rolled out from June 2021. There was an increase of around 65% in the receipt of complaints. 92% have been solved. New lead PB free material has been discovered by the scientists at Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, Bengaluru. It is called cadmium doped silver antimony telluride. It can efficiently convert waste heat to power our small home equipment and automobiles. Most efficient thermoelectric material developed so far use lead as a major constituent element, restricting their use for mass market applications, and this work is supported by Swarn Jayanti Fellowship. Now the Swarn Jayanti Fellowship scheme was launched by Indian government to commemorate India's 50th independence. Now, since it was the first weekly analysis, I have to keep it longer and in detail. I understand a lot of you must be exhausted by now. Even I am while creating it. But trust me, it's all worth it. It's all worth your hard work. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Share the videos. Help many more aspirants. I'll see you in the next one.